define a failing grade for your child's education.
Yeah, today the state auditor put education in California in the high risk category, saying the dropout rate for high schoolers is at 12%. That is higher than the national average.
The auditor also says the graduation rate leaves something to be desired at 79%. And besides those findings, the auditor says California's plan to improve education is risky.
KCRA3's Mike Lurie has been digging into this report all day, and he joins us now in the newsroom with more on what this means for kids in California, Mike.
Well, Gulston and Kelly, it means their future, and California's future is in jeopardy because, as the state auditor said today, we may not have enough college graduates in the future for California to remain competitive economically.
What is the significance of this argument?
These 7th and 8th graders in Peggy Clapper's speech class are learning how to debate, but they may soon be getting a hard lesson about California's future.
Today we have added education to our high-risk issues.
In today's report, the state auditor is warning that California may not have enough money to give $25 billion to local school districts over the next 8 years, because honoring that commitment would require 8 consecutive years of strong economic growth.
We're banking on $25 billion that may or may not be there in the future.
Correct.
Jalen, all right, we'll see you later.
But to educators like Michael Holt, a former teacher of the year, and now an assistant principal at Albert Einstein Middle School, education is an investment that can't be denied.
We have a lot of students who are in poverty. We have a lot of students who have English as their second language, coming from all over the world, because this is an amazing place to be. But if you want them to develop into the citizens of tomorrow, we have to spend the money today.
Spending more on education is something that parents like Priscilla Melgar support.
Maybe more teachers, so that way their classrooms are not so crowded.
State Schools Chief Tom Torlakson was traveling today, but took issue with the auditor's report, saying it's a strange day when efforts to ensure that every California student graduates with college and career readiness are labeled as high risk. The auditor also reported that budget cuts have affected access to California universities. It's a trend that worries Dean Murakami, a psychology professor at American River College and the vice president of the California Federation of Teachers.
Very high-end jobs, those things will go to other states and other places. That's what we're afraid of.
And State Schools Chief Tom Torlakson said his department was not given an opportunity to review the full report before it was released today. The state auditor says, however, the Department of Education did review the K-12 portion of the report, which is the part about them.
So the report is out. People are digesting it. What happens next?
Well, next step would be for the legislature to step up if they want to, and they can call hearings. They can put pressure on fiscal forecasters to see if those numbers, especially that $25 billion, really adds up. We'll know more, of course, when they return next month.
Definitely getting a lot of people's attention.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you, Mike.